Hello, today I will be starting you on your journey from getting you from making sky miners to making full-fledged pots, like an online FNAF game, or mob battlers. But the first step is going to be getting on the server if you haven't already. So, the IP is mcdiamondfire.com. Menu, like this, you have your pots, you have the game menu, shop, and cosmetics. When you first start in, if you don't have a rank, you won't have a lot unlocked, as it goes from the shop or cosmetics. Anything's like code, some blocks are locked off if you don't have ranks or haven't bought them, which you can do with tokens. In the game menu, you can see what other people made, trending pods, the promoted pods, favorites, all that. But what we'll be doing is claiming our first pod. Now, I don't have any left because I've already claimed all of mine, but if it's your first time on, you only have basic pods unlocked. You only have one of them, in fact. When you get ranks, or if you just play, or you purchase them, you can get more. This one, 50 by 50, 100 by 100, 300 by 300. That's more code space and more build space for you. But if it's your first time, you'll only be able to claim a basic plot, so go ahead. Now that we are on our plot, it can seem daunting having all these different items in your inventory. But don't let it scare you, it is actually quite simple. Reference book is the first step you'll want to do. It has many different, for lack of a better word, bangs that you can look through, from the color codes. That's if you want to name an item or send something in chat, perhaps, and give it some color. The rest, we'll take a look at later. These are all your code blocks. These are what you will be utilizing to code. And yes, it is coding. Just as much as Scratch is very similar or a representation of a block-based Java, this is simply Java with the spigot API on it. You don't need to know what that means. It doesn't really matter. It is event-driven, meaning that each time that a player does something in-game, specific code will run as a result of it. Let me show you. For instance, if a player joins the game, you can do stuff from kicking them, setting variables, giving them potion effects, sending messages. For instance, sending a message, which is under the communication tab, taking a value, a text value, because we want to send something to them. Simply holding the item, saying hi. Let me make sure the pod has a whitelist, so that nobody random joins. It says hi in chat. Simply because I joined, and then it ran code from starting here. It hit this block. It says send message. So it'll send a message to the player that joined. Let's say I wanted to do something else, just to show that there's many things that you can utilize this for. Let's give them a potion effect. Take that out, because we're not giving a high potion, we're going to give them a potion effect. For instance, a jump boost, which I got from, again, the values, a potion effect. I did jump boost, so let's give them a time, permanent, and an amplifier of 2. Put it in there, and then join. I now have a jump boost. I've seen people who try to use processes or call functions. You do not need to do that. Simply joining, and then it'll run any code afterwards. You can add as many of these as you want. And you can do stuff like leave, or when a player does a command. However, as you see there, underneath that, it says Emperor exclusive, meaning that to do this one, you need a rank. First off, such as a click event. The description says right and left clicking blocks or breaking blocks, as an example. These are things that when a player clicks on their mouse, will run. Movement events. This is when a player jumps or walks or flies. When a player is moving. Simple enough. Then item events. Stuff like dropping an item or picking up an item. Or even eating the item. Damaging events. Death events. When someone dies. When someone has been damaged. No need, at this time, to use call functions or processes for anything. I will be getting further into detail about the other box in later videos, but I just wanted to give a brief example and description of what you can do with the very basics. Let me give you one more example. A player leaves, let's send them the message, bye. I join. Gives me my potion effect still. I leave, and then it says bye. In case you were wondering, I am typing slash play to go into play mode, slash dev to go into code mode, slash code also works. And if you wanted to build, which you can do while in dev mode, but specifically build without all this clutter in your inventory, you can do slash build. I will stay in slash dev. It is very fun to work on DiamondFire or to code on DiamondFire. And if you are patient with it, you can earn just as well as I have, and you can make plots even more complex. Thank you for watching.